right below A first time.
Yeah, he's got all
heads down. Literally.
Okay.
Oh,
1v1.
Yeah, 12. I guess I'll be my own mod in my chat.
Yo guys, what is up? It is your boy J2HD here coming to another video today. If you guys are new, you already know what to do. Subscribe, like, notification game. Let me know you guys in the comment section down below. Make sure you guys also follow me on my Twitch. I stream every single day. We're on the road to 80,000 followers. Thank you guys so much for your love and support. That link is in the description below. Do not miss another stream. Guys, also, I got a few questions in the comment section below. I do have a scuff code. That scuff code is code SMOOTH. If you guys use code SMOOTH at the checkout, it's 5% off your purchase for scuff. It's the same thing for G Fuel, but G Fuel is 10%, and 10% as well for code TROFREAK. Any discount code I have is code SMOOTH at the checkout. So make sure you guys use that, all right? For today's video, let's try to reach 250 likes today. As you guys see in the title right now, this video is a little different. So I was, you know, thinking about some just content ideas and stuff like that. And I had an idea about, like, why not tell a story about, or just like my personal life. And I get a lot of questions asked about, like, how I met somebody or how we formed together or this and that. And if you guys don't end up watching, if you're not able to catch my streams, you guys may miss some personal stories that I may talk about myself, my likes and dislikes, and, you know, whatever the case may be, some situations I've been in. So for this story, we're gonna talk about how Swag, aka Chris, to me, you know, how we came together, how we met, and what's our story on our friendship. Basically, it just started like this. In high school, we went to school together. And actually, him and his brother and his family, they were a grade year above me. So when I was a freshman, they were sophomores. So I came into school, and I was actually friends with his brother, BJ, more than I was with Chris. And so, you know, we would kick and hang out, do whatever, you know, go play ball, you know, case may be. Then one day, one summer, I think it was during the summer, you know, I came over to the crib, and this dude is like, you know, hunchback, like scratching his chest, watching like Judge Judy or something. I don't know. I think it was Jerry Springer. He was big into Jerry Springer back in the day. So he's like watching Jerry Springer, right? And so I got this Xbox, you know, and stuff in my hand. I'm like, what's the vibe here? You know, what are we doing? And so, like, you know, I end up plugging up the Xbox 360 by the time, and that's when I had back in the day. And at the time, I brought over MW2. And so back in the day, you couldn't have, like, portable online, if you guys know. Like, there was wireless routers for the Xbox, but, like, I don't even think at the time they were, like, out. So, like, everything was Ethernet. And so we had to play LAN, so we were just doing 1v1s. So we were just doing 1v1 quickscopes, and, you know, I was smoking all of them, 20-3, 20-1, 20-4, like just doing whatever I wanted. And it's the same thing today. It's just, you know, if I beat him, you know, I can still whoop Chris in a 1v1, trust me. It's just, he'll get memed and, you know, he'll get made fun of. It just, I let him have his day. You know what I mean? I can take the heat. So, you know, it's like, you know, when you're a kid and your pops let you beat you all the time in one-on-one, or like your pops will beat you in one-on-one all the time, and then that one day he lets you beat you and you felt good. That's kind of where we're at now. So, you know, we had a lot of fun doing the 1v1s and stuff like that, and he was like, bro, I gotta get this joint myself. You know, he ended up getting the Xbox as well, and then we just started playing all the time. Like all the time, every day after school. You know, we'll go to basketball practice, we'll hoop, you know, do our thing, you know, go to practice, have fun, whoop-de-whoop, hop on the sticks. And so I remember one day going to school, you know, random day, and we just were talking about it, and we came up with the idea of just making a dual YouTube channel, which never really came to fruition, but we talked about doing it because, you know, we played Call of Duty that much. And so the reason why it didn't really work because of my end. So I grew up in a bit more of a strict household, which is, I wasn't really allowed to play the game during school days. Now I still would, because the game system was in my room. I didn't understand how that happened. The game system was in my room, but I wasn't allowed to play it until like the weekend. But so what would happen was I would get home before my parents did from work. So as I'm getting home, I'm at the house by myself. I would hop right on the game, hop right on the sticks, and I start playing with the boys. but I could like hear when the garage door would open. So when the garage door was opening, or like I hear them slam the door to walk into the crib, I would be like, yes, I gotta go. And I'll get off, or like I'll just hop instantly. You know, back in the day, it would say your gamer tag. So it's like JoJo has left the Xbox party. So like they knew my parents were home. So the dual YouTube channel, we post a few videos, but it didn't really, it wasn't as consistent as we could have been because of my end. So, you know, he took that YouTube thing and he went to where he is now today with it. And, you know, I also did my own thing with YouTube. I did post a few videos on my channel here and I have some old videos as well, but it, you know, it was over the years that when I really started getting consistent in it, and like I went to school and had a different life, and like we went through different experiences to where we get to today. Basically, and then with that, with our friendship, with just playing so much, you know, you get to grow and you learn more about the person. You kick one up to school every day, and we just had so much mutual interest. We both play basketball, we both love video games, we like movies, we like to go, you know, eat at certain places, you know what I mean? He may get like, he may go get a cheeseburger, I may get a hamburger, you know, I get made fun of if the cheese is on the burger and I take the cheese off the burger because I don't eat cheese on my burger, but I'll eat a pizza. Yes, we get that, that's me. But, you know, even with our unique qualities, it just turned out to have a dope friendship. So, you know, and even today, and that's even with his whole family, even with his brother as well, you know, BJ may not play as much video games as Chris and I did, but like, I still had that unique friendship that I had with his whole family. So it's just, it was just a close niche and a tight bond. And like I said, I get asked this question a whole lot about just how, like, you know, how do we met, if it was like through, like, it was through gaming or whatever case may be. We just happened to be, like I said, childhood friends. And so, and some people may have the same story as, you know, Chris and I, or some people are just, you know, they're fascinated about what the dynamic is there. But, you know, if you guys also have like just the same type of dynamic we have, where you and your friends are at home, you know, some of you guys who are maybe younger or in high school, kids, and just watch me, who are younger and you see this, like, it could be the same thing as you. You just go home, you go play COD every day thinking nothing of it. And then, you know, you start trying to turn your hobby into something that's just fun and you do every day. And, you know, you're showing your passion, you're showing your love, and you're showing just your unique bond and your unique friendship. And it pans out to just be something successful in that, you know, we're blessed to, you know, I'll say I'm blessed to be here to do YouTube and do Twitch and to have a platform today. But it's even better and more dope that I did it with, you know, people that I grew up with who were like, were along the ride with me. And with that, it's always super dope for sure. So as I said previously, I get asked these questions a whole lot. So I just said, why not make it to the story time? So let me know if you guys enjoyed this story time with JaySoomHD. You know, if there's any other questions or any other experiences or stories you want to learn about me, let me know in the comment section below. You know, and like I said, if you guys enjoy this stuff, I'll make more videos about doing this story time type of stuff. I love trying to create this personal connection with you guys because, you know, may not only know JaySoomHD, but you don't know the story behind it. And like I said, if you guys are not able to make my streams or watch my streams, definitely this will be a great way for, you know, us to connect and, you know, learn about, you guys can learn about my life and my story. So like I said, let me know in the comment section below if you guys did enjoy this video. Leave a like, comment, also subscribe if you guys are new, make sure you guys have notifications on. And like I said, who knows? Maybe the next story is about how the new squad came together. Maybe the next one is about my first kiss. I don't know. We'll figure it out. But I love doing this. I love, you know, having this type of connection and this type of bond and you guys learning about me, because I don't want to feel like I'm such a stranger to you guys. I don't want to be just the guy who drops class setups. I want you guys to also know the story behind JaySoomHD. Anyways, guys, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I would love to do more storytelling and more story times with JaySoom in the future. Anyways, y'all, I'll catch y'all next time, and y'all stay smooth. Peace.